for about 12 months now, these heat exchangers have been a real problem. They've been leaking coolant into the exhaust, and I've chased them around a bit, put new tube nests in, which I don't think I needed to do, and we eventually took them apart. I've taken them off and had them completely rebuilt. It was quite expensive, but they rebuilt the whole heat exchanger. So now our cooling system's back to being new, and it just had to be done. I suppose 17 years, you can't complain, but at least they're back to being new, and I feel very confident with them now. So we're ready to go cruising again. Well, the last 6 months have been pretty hectic. A lot of work to do on the boat. We've rebuilt our heat exchangers on the motors. I put new radar on, and of course I had to repair the dinghy as well, or replace it. But anyway, all the jobs are done, and it's time for us to head out again. It's late in the season. We're in September now, and it's a bit late to be heading to the Whitsundays, but we're going to head north anyway and have a bit of a poke around up around Bundaberg and maybe Lady Musgrave. I've got new crew on board, so you'll meet her very shortly. And yeah, we're off to have a good time. Keep following our videos. Thanks. We have provisioned at the marina, and Bev decides to relax on the foredeck as we head downriver. Before we leave the Coomera, we fuel up at Hope Harbour.
How long?
About 10 seconds.
Out into the broad water, where it's pretty busy. Well, it's Sunday. We were going to leave on Monday, but the weather was so good, we decided to come out today. We've got our fuel at Hope Harbour, and we've decided we're just going to head up to Millionaire's Row at the pin, and that'll be our anchorage for the night. Well, this is the new dinghy. You'll remember from one of my other videos, I trashed the inflatable coming across the Wide Bay Bar. And I'm a bit over the inflatables. That last one, I seem to be gluing things on it all the time. The sun in Queensland tends to degrade the glue in them. So I had a real problem with it. So I've gone for a new dinghy. This is called a Spindrift. They're made in Western Australia. They're a little catamaran hull. And it's a good little unit. I've had it on the boat for about 2 months now, and I'm really enjoying it. It's a lot lighter than the inflatable was. It's a lot less hassle with bits falling off it and that sort of thing. And I think it's going to be a lot better in the long run, a lot less maintenance. So some of the features of it are, it's got a little anchor well up the front. So little spot there to put your anchor. Great bit of storage up under the front. It's got a thwart across the tunnel. Storage under the stern here for fuel and other gear. Unfortunately, I had to sell my old outboard because it was a bit too big for this smaller dinghy. So I've gone for a new 10 horsepower Suzuki, and that does the job pretty well. So all in all, it's a great little unit. Thank you.
other thing that let me down over the last 17 years was a radar, and I've had to replace it. I've bought a new second-hand model, but it hasn't done much work, and we've got new radar. The magnetron in the old one died, and the unit was that old that we couldn't replace it, so it meant we had to do something about it. So I've got a new 16 nautical mile radar that'll be our eyes at night time.
It's good to have the jobs complete, be out of the marina and out cruising again.